Okay. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the online prize ceremony of the 2021 Chinese Classic Text OCR Challenge organized by Research Support and Digital Initiatives, CHK Library. Here we have our participating teams and audiences online watching us, and some of our colleagues attend here. We are happy to have Professor Alan Chen, Provost and LS Lee, Professor of Chinese Culture, and Ms. Louise Jones, our University Librarian, here in Digital Scholarship Lab to officiate the ceremony. I'm Katie, Digital Scholarship Librarian here, who takes care and in charge of the lab. And I'm the one who is always communicating with our participating team during the challenge. We are happy that the challenge has come to an end, and we have very satisfactory results. And thanks to all the teams who have demonstrated their expertise in showcasing their Chinese classic text OCR technology. For today's prize ceremony, first of all, our head of digital initiatives, Rani, will give a short, a brief summary on the whole challenge. Then Professor Chen and Ms. Jones will deliver their officiating speech. And then Professor Chen will present the prizes to our winning teams. And finally, our champion team will give a short presentation. So now, Ryan, your turn, please.
Okay, so good morning, Mr. Professor Chen, Ms. Jones, Professor Lai, colleague and friend. Welcome here to the 2021 Chinese Classic Text OCR Challenges. I will give a fact and figure of this new challenges organized by the CHK Library. Okay, so you can see the timeline. We announced this OCR challenges in February. In March, we have a brief online section to the briefing. And then in the March 17, we start the 10-day challenges. In April, we announced the result. Finally, we reached today as a ceremony, and then we, the champion will also present their technology. Okay, so you can see from here, this is the presentation team. There's a 33 team register. You can see mainly from research and academic, 16 from commercial, and 14 from others. By regions, there's a 13 team from China, 14 from Taiwan, and 5 team from Hong Kong, and the 1 team from US. So this is an international competition. Okay, so 30 teams start the challenges. Finally, 10 teams complete the challenges. So this is 10 teams. So also would like to thank you all the thank you for their participation. Okay, so you can see from here, this is the 10-day result of the top three. You can see the two teams is really head to head. And after that, the team D also coming up here. So this is quite a competitive challenges. The detailed result, you can also see from this website. Okay, so we talk about the challenges. So what kind of challenges that they face? First, there's the 10-day challenges. Every day we will have 50 pages per day, and total is 500 pages, and 74,000 characters that has been recognized. So they need to develop the online submission system so we can upload the TIFF and then download the results. And then they have to complete the OCR challenges within the process within the one hours. So the other challenges is accuracy. This is very important. So they have to recognize the original characters, not the company use characters. So you can see some of the example here. They have to recognize this old text. And also the image quality, we choose some of the blur and some image noise. So to make them more challenges for them. This is some of our early stage digitization text. can see from here. So the other testing, we're testing the test lines segmentation. One of the example is the double line text. This is quite common for the ancient text. There's some inline annotation notes. So the system must be recognize this text in one single line. Okay, so more challenges, variety. We mainly using the this the two Dao text, the Lü Zhou Quan Shu, Tai Shen Yun Men Gong Fu for these two texts for the for these challenges. But starting from day 7, we're adding other books from our Lingnan collection, Chinese medicine and Chinese rare book. So we make more variety so they can test their how to recognize different fonts and print. Okay, so overall, this is all the challenges they are facing. So finally, we would like to thank you, Professor Lai, and the Center of Study of Tao Culture to provide the challenges text. So this is and this is the image is showing most challenges text in this result. Thank you.
Thank you, Ryan. And I think that you have a bit understanding of what we have done and what we have achieved in these 2 months. Okay, so now let me invite Professor Alan Chan to give us a speech. Professor Chan, please.
Thank you, Kitty. Ms. Louise Jones, University Librarian, Professor Lai Ji Team, Director, Center for the Study of Taoist Culture. Distinguished guests, dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It is my great pleasure to be with you this morning on this happy occasion. It is a prize-giving ceremony, which is always a happy occasion. And on such an occasion, of course, first of all, I would like to extend my warmest congratulations, not only to the winners, but to all the teams who participated in this challenge. Thanks must also go to the organizers of the competition, especially so because this is the inaugural edition of the CUHK Chinese Classic Text OCR Challenge. Let me give a few remarks to express how important this competition is to the university. OCR technology is really transforming how research is done in the humanities. From its beginning in the early 20th century, the technology was initially designed to help the visually impaired. But over the years, actually in a very short span of time, the technology has developed tremendously into not only a text recognition tool, but also a tool that enables searches, generating new data, which would allow us to gather new evidence leading to new insight. In many ways, technology is really reshaping the future of research in the humanities. That's the first point. CUHK is at the forefront of technological research, seeking to expand the frontiers of especially digital humanities in this context, allowing more scholars to access the material that is at our disposal, making connections leading to new discoveries. And in this respect, the university will continue to invest in such research. The second point I would like to share is that Chinese studies has been and will continue to be a major pillar of strength, a research focus for the Chinese University of Hong Kong. We aim to be the leader in this field. We aim to be also the custodian of tradition. We aim to be able to spread our passion for Chinese research with scholars and students from all around the globe. The history of the university cannot be divorced from our dedication to China research. So in this respect, we are really pleased that we are able to host the inaugural edition of the 中国古籍文字自动识别挑战 for the first time. And finally, the last point I want to make is this. Scholarship learning transcends national cultural boundaries. For OCR and related digital humanities research to flourish, we need fruitful international collaboration. And in this respect, CUHK also hopes to be a leader in galvanizing interest, in bringing interested organizations together, extending our knowledge, extending our horizon, as we develop more tools that would enable scholars and students to reach a deeper understanding of the rich tradition of Chinese classical texts. So I hope this is only the beginning of a long series of OCR challenge competition. And once again, I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate the winners and also to invite more participants to join this challenge in the next edition of the competition. Thank you very much, and I wish everyone a very pleasant day ahead. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Chen, and we hope that we will be organizing it again in the future. And now let me invite Ms. Julie Jones to give us a speech. Ms. Jones, please.
So good morning, everyone, and a welcome on behalf of the CUHK Library. I really would like to convey my thanks to all the participants and the enthusiasm that you showed through this grueling 10-day, and it was a grueling 10-day challenge, has made it a really positive experience for everybody. So the OCR challenge actually marks the fifth anniversary of the Library's Digital Scholarship Lab, this wonderful room that we have, and the Digital Scholarship, the RSDI team, that have been really pioneering and making substantial progress on advocating for digital scholarship at the university. In fact, over the 5 years, the RSDI team have actually delivered over 100 workshops and two successful digital scholarship symposium covering topics such as network analysis, text analysis, GIS, and we've really developed our expertise in this area. The Digital Scholarship Lab has also been a welcoming venue for 240 research and research project presentations used by various departments. So for example, we've had seminars on Chinese archaeology here. We've had the launch of the World Urban Database. And as Professor Lai was just saying, it's heavily used for teaching. So our research support and digital initiatives team not only deliver workshops and training, but they're also responsible for partnering with faculties on digitization and digital scholarship projects. And we're just delighted to have Professor Lai here, who's one of our most important partners. And we provide the infrastructure, which is the CUHK Digital Repository, which now hosts over, I think, 600,000 digital objects and 7.5 million Chinese characters. And these range from characters on Oracle bones through to Cantonese opera postbills, and really our most treasured rare books, 15 of which have just been accepted into the National Catalogue of Precious Ancient Books. So we have worked with over 30 CUHK departments and research centres and other institutions such as the Shanghai Library, McGill University and the Beishan Tang Foundation to digitise collections such as our Chinese medicine text collection and our latest Lingnan collection. Really, these collections are what's driving our interest in Chinese OCR, and that the challenge that we have is we have a lot of digitized material, but how we then turn it into the data is the real issue for us, and how we do that quickly and efficiently. And this is why we're really interested in how machine learning can help us. And this challenge has really moved our thinking forward. So the OCR challenge has been an organizational challenge as well for the RSDI team, who have dedicated themselves to making this event such a success. And I know there's been a huge amount of work that's gone on behind the scenes, evenings, weekends, etc. And I'd really like to thank the team for preparing this. And I'm sure this first challenge will have a lasting impact. So finally, I'd like to thank everybody who's joined us in person and virtually for today for the ceremony. And I am delighted that this was a truly global competition, because we really benefit from those regional and international collaborations. And you know, if you're interested in exploring collaboration with us in the future, you know who to contact, Kitty and Ryan. So, because I mean, one of the key aims is really to facilitate the exchange of knowledge and technology amongst our researchers and industrial partners. And I think the presentation that we're going to see in a minute from the winning team will show us how we can take forward all of this work with the new technology. So finally, my congratulations to the champions, to all the winning teams, and above all to all the participants and the team who made this happen. It's very exciting, and I hope that we can build on this first Classical Chinese OCR challenge and explore together how we can exploit the technology to really benefit China Studies research at CUHK, but globally as well. So thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Jones, and I hope that DS Lab here can continue to be our CHK members' place for our research activities. Okay, so here we come to the happy moment that we'll be presenting the prizes to our winning teams. Our three winning teams will all be awarded with e-vouchers, and the champion will have the e-badge for display. Let me invite Professor Chen to present the prizes to our winning teams. We'll be starting from the second runner-up. Okay, the second runner-up is Deep Blue AI from Shen Yan Keji, Beijing Youxian Gongzi. The team consists of three members joining this challenge, and their introduction, Deep Blue AI 团队, 在OCR上已有自行研发的繁体字古籍识别演算法，目前与一些公司达成合作，还有部分公司进行商业谈判。Deep Blue AI will be awarded for $3,000 of e-voucher. Professor Chen, please. The e-voucher will be delivered to our second runner-up team. the Deep Blue AI. Thank you. Congratulations to the second runner-up. Yeah, thank you, thank you. 徐先生, thank you. 谢谢。 Okay, congratulations to our Deep Blue AI team. And now here, we now have the first runner-up. Yeah, Jun. It goes to SCUT DLBC Lab from South China University of Technology, Guangzhou, China. And they have four members. And here they are giving a very quite long introduction on their technology. The Deep Learning and Vision Computing Lab, DLVC Lab, 华南理工大学电子与资讯学院，团队主要研究方向为文字识别、光学资源辨识 OCR， 手写文字识别、手写输入法、 自然场景文字检测与识别、 文档图像分析与识别、 深度学习及其应用、 电脑视觉及影像处理、 人工智慧应用系统。 And their OCR is programming is self-developed. 他们的程式模型有三个部分组成， 包括特征提取网路、 资源定位识别以及版面分析。 其中特征提取网路针对资源的定位识别问题，他们借鉴Faster LCNN 网路，在 RPN 阶段输出二分类结果，然后在那个 ROL head 阶段直接输入输出资源分类结果。基于检测到的单字，他们基于线验规则，对同一个版面内横坐标相近的矩形框进行合并，借着从上到下输出符合。 正确读取顺序的资源分类结果。为了进一步提高模型的识别性能，他们训练的文本型识别模型，利用 LSTM 网络的序列建模能力，建模古籍文本的语义特征。The first one hub team will be awarded for $5,000 of e-vouchers. Professor Chen, please. Yeah, Team C here, yeah. Congratulations to Team C. And now we will announce the champion. The champion, Guan Jun, goes to ASCDC, Academia Center, a Center for Digital Cultures, Taiwan, led by Dr. Wang Xiang'an, in film members. And they had the accuracy rate of over 90% during the challenge. We will leave them to give the presentation on their technology later. And Professor Chen, please present to them the $8,000 of e-vouchers and the e-badge delivering to them in one log. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, congratulations to the champion and thank you Professor Chen in presenting the prizes to the winning teams. Please be seated. And now we will have the short presentation by the champion team ASCDC. Dr. Wang, please.
各位与会者好，今天很荣幸可以受到香港凤大学的邀请来这边对大家做一个技术的简报。那我们是来自台湾的中央研究院数位文化中心，可以听到好的，那我就直接报告哈。好，我们是来自台湾的中央研究院数位文化中心。 那我们这次比赛的团队成员有三位，就是由我王翔安，还有我的两位同事，就是丁胜跟刘品平。那就由我来为大家做一个技术的简报。那由于这个主办单位给我的时间大概是十到十五分钟，所以我不会讲的太技术方面，我不会讲的太深入，不过我会给大家一些 这个参考的文献的来源，所以如果有一些比较技术上的东西，你们可以去参考这些文献，可以了解一下比较深入的技术。那在这一次会议里面，我们采用的是结合人工智慧跟人类智慧的一个整合的技术。那在整个辨识这个处理流程里面，我们大概主要分成八个主要的部分，那一下我就一一介绍。那首先呢，我们会先做一个图像的处理。那在这个处理里面，大概主要分成两个部分，一个是先我们会将彩色的这个图像影像转换成黑白。那在这个转换过程中，我们会有做两个事情，第一个就是我们会参考这个 FastNL means denoising 的这个方法，那这个 reference 在下面大家可以看到这个论文，然后会先做一些杂讯的去除，那另外呢 也会使用这个 Marty Osus 的一个方法来做一个二质化。那做完之后呢，因为 有一些这个影像它是歪斜的，所以我们会利用这个 histogram 的一种投影的方法来做一个旋转，那找出一个最佳的旋转角度。啊，这个右边就是一个示意，就是经过旋转之后它图像就会变得比较正一点。那接下来我们会做这个版面的分析，因为这一次的比赛中是要将这个输赢也就是版心的部分去除，所以我们大概会分成三个主要的版面的区块。那第一个就是红色这个文字的区块，也就是主要要辨识的区块。那绿色部分就是版心的部分，版心就是我们要去除的部分，还有背景的部分。那在这个上面我们是参考这个类似 UNet 这一个模型，就是记忆学习里面的一个模型架构，所以像左边是原始的影像，那我们会经过这个 UNet 转换以后，大家可以看到就是右边这个红色这个区域，就是我们认为它是有文字的区域的部分。那接下来呢，我们会做一个这个标记的移除，因为在这一次大会里面也是规定这种标记或者是标点是没有存在，所以我们会先定义一些这个标记的 template， 大家可以在下面看到类似这些就是标记的这个范例。那在右边的图应该有很多标记，我们只是框出两个来告诉大家说像这样的东西之后就会被消除掉。所以我们就可以看到说，在我们整个这个文本里面到底有哪些地方是有标记的，我们会在这上面在最右边先出来，经过我们的处理之后。然后接下来呢，我们会进行这个文字的定位或者是文字的侦测。那在这个步骤里面，我们又分成了三个部分。那首先呢，我们会做一个叫做 mask 的prediction， 就是我们要先侦测到底哪边是有一个文字的地方。那这边也是使用机器学习的这个 DenseNet 的这个方法，就类似这种方法，然后也来组成一个类似 UNet 的一个模型的架构。然后这个如果大家有兴趣也可以看看这两篇这个论文。然后在这个步骤我们就会产生出右边的这个 warm mask 的一个的一个 output 的一个结果。然后呢，这跟一般做 word detection 的方法有一点不太一样，就是因为一般的方法可能用 anchor base 的这种方法的话，很容易受到 anchor 的 size 的影响，然后会产生类似相互重叠 bounding bus 啊这一些东西。那我们就预测比较简单的，就是的这种应该说比较单纯的这个 warm mask 的方法来做这个事情。那这个在做 warm mask 的时候，我们还会考虑这个垂直的这个关联或者是水平之间的关联。那这个主要是来用来处理这个mask 之间到底要怎么样组成行，或者是因为有时候这个行跟行之间的关系，或者是有一些大字小字混合在同一行，或是小字并排的这种情况。所以我们也训练这个，我们会取出这样的 mask。 所以在这个步骤里面我们就会产出三种这个不同的这个 mask，那这个就是有真实文本产出的结果。好，那在产生 mask 之后啊，我们就开始要去侦测这个 bounding box 就是文字的区域啊，那在这边我们采用是这个以 URL 这个演算法为一个基础啊，来进行一些修改。那主要就也跟刚刚提到，就是我们减少这个 anchor 的这个机制啊，然后直接预测 bounding box 的一个长宽的一个范围哈。那输入的时候，我们就是输前面比较提到的这个 warmask 的资讯哈。 然后经过这个处理之后呢，就可以看到这个我们会把这个 warmask 跟文字，然后放到我们的 model 里面以后，就会对于字产生出像右边这些有这个 bounding box 有这个外框的一个结果。那针对这个 bounding box 的这个结果，因为有时候它还是会产生一些重叠啊，或者是这个。 有时候会有交杂的一些情况，那所以我们会对这个 bounding box 做一些合并跟过滤哈。那这边大概我们就是采用我们的这个 heuristic 的方法哈，就是我们还是自己会撰写一些程式，然后来做这个根据 bounding box 重叠的比例啊，还有它的尺寸的大小，或者是呢，在这个 bounding box 里面是不是有一些异常的黑色或白色像素比例差异。 太大的这种情况来做一些处理。那在确定好这个 bounding box 之后，我们会再进行一个叫做区域二质化的一个方法哈。那主要原因就是因为在这一次比赛里面的这个影像啊，有的时候它的同一页影像里面，它就有深跟浅差异非常大的情况啊。那甚至也有这个许多文字是有刚才大家可以看到这种透底，就是。 底的这个文字透到前面这个情况，所以如果单纯使用全局的这个二质化的这个方法的话，没有办法做到很好，所以我们就会针对每一个字再去做一个Mani-Os 的一个二质化的一个处理。那在这边大家就可以看到说，如果我们再经过一个处理之后，就可以去掉一些这个所谓这个杂讯的一个部分。 然后接下来我们就开始进行做文字的分类，也就是大家一般认知的这个辨识的部分。那在这边我们是主要是参考这个 Inception ResNet 的这个 model 来作为我们辨识的模型。那在这里要特别感谢就是中央研究院历史语言研究所和汉奇资料库还有哈佛燕京图书馆，他们过去提供了我们一些很高品质的这个。 影像还有这个文字档，让我们有大量资料可以训练这个文字的分类。所以经过前面步骤之后，我们最后进行分类以后，就可以产出这个文字的这个结果。那确定好文字的输出之后，我们就要开始进行这个排版因为这次大会的这个比赛规则相当严格就是如果你的排版输出如果换行错误的话，就整个文件它都会计算成错误所以文字排版这一块在这次比赛里面也是相当重要的部分。那这边呢，我们是还是使用这个heuristic 方法，就是自己客制化演算法来进行这个文字排版。那在排版的时候，当然主要就是考量每行文字的这个宽度，还有行与行之间的距离。那还有文字的这个面积，还有长宽比啊，然后还有来判断说，在这个图像里面到底有没有大小字混合的情况。然后接下来我们就要判断这个哪些字如果有大小字，到底要怎么样把它串成在同一行。 而不会进行换行。那有时候是整行都是小字的这个双行小字，你必须要把它串接在一起。那所以在我们的这个方法里面也会做这样处理，然后最后才决定说到底要这一行的文字输出要的顺序要怎么样来处理。 那最后我们会做一个这个文字的修正，就是说我们这边使用的是一个 Ngram 的一个 model 来做这个文字的修正。那这边有一个简单的例子啊，就是这个方法我们大概可以分成就是双向的，或者是由前往后推的，或者是由后往前推的一个方法。那主要就是根据这个蓝色框，就是我们要假设我们要修正的字，我们会根据这个蓝色框的前后资讯，或者是前面的资讯或后面的资讯来修正这个蓝色框里面的内容。那在下面也有一篇我们过去发表的一篇论文，如果大家有兴趣也可以到这个论文来观看。那在修正的时候，我们也不是单纯只有考虑这个文字的结果，我们会根据这个影像的这个信心分数，然后来做说最后到底要输出的文字是什么。所以例如像这个如果一开始来辨识这个苏东坡的坡是错误的时候，虽然它在影像里面可能辨识的是最好，可是经过这个文字后修正的模型之后，我们会把它辨识成这个凸字旁的坡。好，那关于 OCR 的部分我们大概就报告到这边。如果大家未来有一些想要深入了解，可以去参考刚提到一些 paper， 然后也或者是也很欢迎跟我们一起交流。那再占用他一点点时间，也帮我们数文化中心宣传一下，我们数文化中心也发展了一套叫数位人文研究平台，就是或者是叫数字人文的这个平台。那它是一个这个免费然后而且有高效能的一个云端环境，大家都可以免费来使用。然后呢，在这个平台上面已经有很多文字分析工具了，像 Ngram 或者是刚才提到关联分析、社会网络分析等等，然后也有 GIS 的这些功能，我们把非常多的功能都整合在这个平台上面。然后在我的平台上也帮大家借接好了很多资料库，像这个中医院的汉籍啊，或者是 C-text， 或者是像 Canrepo， 或者是很多这个研究的资源啊，那文本或者是这个中文的词汇档啊，你都可以在上面可以使用。那当然，如果你有兴趣贡献你自己的这个文本或者是你的这个词汇档等等研究成果，你也可以在上面开放你自己的研究成果，或者是可以在上面让大家来观看你怎么样做数位人文研究的这个过程。所以如果有兴趣，大家可以到上述的这个网站来使用我们的平台。那也顺道一提就是说我们希望未来也可以把这个 OCR 的技术放到这个平台上面，以至于让未来有一些文本可以直接在这个平台上面被辨识出来，然后进行到后面的这个数位人文的这个运用。好的，那我今天报告就到这边结束。那如果什么未来有想要跟我联系也可以透过这个 mail 来跟我联系，或者是也欢迎大家到我们数文化中心来看看我们的一些研究成果。好，谢谢。
Audiences have the interest in connecting with the participating teams for idea exchange on the Chinese classic text OCR technology. And please visit our OCR website in which the link now is in the chat box. And you will find some of our teams who have left the contacts in the for the idea exchange. So, so now the ceremony has come to an end. Yeah. And thank you, Professor Alan Chan, Ms. Jones has left. Professor Lai, our participating teams, and all of you in joining the ceremony. Okay. We hope this challenge is just the first one, and we'll be able and we have the chance to organize in the future. So everyone, stay healthy, and thank you, and goodbye.